Hi, on this video tutorial, we are going to learn how to use a package from Spatie called Spatie CSP. So for those who are not familiar with security headers, now it's going to be a good moment and I'm going just to go to the package and show to you what does it mean and what is the benefits for you to use it. So this package called Laravel CSP from Spatie allows you to actually configure a tag, a header, an HTTP header that will allow you to restrict and to reinforce the security on your website. This package was created, well, it was inspired by a blog post made by David Gilbertson, where he actually explained about how malicious behavior can happen on your website and how you actually can restrict most of them using these content security policy headers that will allow you to resolve this issue. In this case, this package, it focuses specifically on one HTTP header, but there are more that actually you can use later on outside of this package. So I'm just going to install it here and then we'll see how we can use it on the website and how you can actually extend it and configure it for your needs. So I'm just going to install it right now. Composer required. Spatie Laravel CSP, and while it installs, let's go here to securityheaders.io, where you can test your website and see your rating. For instance, I'm just going to show you about the Laraning.com to see, because I'm already using this package, and you can see that it will detect that. So I'm on, in a moment I'm rating D, so I'm just using the Spatie CSP that will use this content security policy HTTP header that is being configured on my website. And all the other ones that are in red, I'm currently not using them. That's why I'm so low one here, but it's the same actually as Google. If you actually see the Google one, it's also on the security report rating D. They actually don't use the content security policy header. They use other two, the XSS protection and the X-frame options. So now that we just installed the Laravel package, let's just deploy the config file. So I'm just going to copy this line here and just click enter. And this is just the default installation of a Laravel web application. Here inside you have this CSP config file. So this is where everything starts. So after you install the package, after you install the configuration file, you can see here that there is some attributes that I'm going to explain. So this policy one is a class that will be used by this package that you will configure your directives inside this HTTP header. In this case, there is one already that comes from Spatie called basic on this Spatie CSP policies /basic. Class, and here as you can see, Spatie already configures a lot of directives for this HTTP header. I'm not going to enter into too much in detail. I suggest you to see the documentation and notes that I placed on this tutorial, because there is here a Firefox, in this case developers Mozilla CSP, and here you'll see that there is a specification for all of these HTTP headers that we'll see, and I'm just going to open the file, the page here, so we can follow it up later on. So getting back here, these are the directives, base, connect, default, imagine all of them, this is self. So self, for instance, means that we will load content specifically from, in this case, only from my own web server. So for instance, if I see a style here that says self, means that if I try to load a link that sources to an external URL, then it will not load that one. It will give an error saying that there is a security violation because that source, it's not from my web servers, but from an external URL. So this is the policy one, and then report only policies. This is for testing purposes, if you want just to report and not actually to apply them, just to see the violations. Then report URI. In case you want to use a website that will, instead, in case that you have a violation, then it immediately sends that violation to that URL, and then in this case report URI, and then .com. You can register an account there. It's free until a certain limit of alerts. And then from there on, you receive an alert directly in case there is a security violation on your website. The enable it is just if you want to enable it or not. And then the nonce generator, this is to generate a random string. We are going to see this just in a couple of seconds. For now, you don't change this. But we will change this policy later on, and I'll show you how, why we are going to do it. So let's just trigger the website here, PHP Artisan Serve. And let's just open a new window here. So for now, nothing happens. I'm on a normal Laravel page. And actually, we are going to use this default web application to actually run our first CSP headers there. So I'm just going to open here the developer tools on the Firefox. I'm going to the F5. I go to the network. I click here on the first one that says slash, and then as you can see here on the right, it says response headers and request headers, right? So these are the headers that are being sent. Right now, we are not sending any security headers by default. So to use now these security headers by default, if you go here to the documentation, it says that there is a middleware already that you can use. So let's copy paste this middleware to our web group on our middleware kernel. So app, HTTP, kernel, and then on the web, I'm going to put this Spatie CSP at CSP headers. So at this moment, when I'm going to press here an F5, I'm going to start using this middleware that will inject these content security headers, in this case, a specific one that we are going to see. And by default, it will immediately load all of those directives that are here on this basic policy that we saw. So if I open again this config CSP, and then this basic one, these are the directives that are being injected on this header. So I'm going to do an F5, and you see that something happened. So actually, everything stopped. It says Laravel, just like Times New Roman, right? And then some links here that are not even styled. The page was loaded, as you can see here, and if you click on it all, nothing else was loaded. So again, if I go back here and I just remove this middleware and I do an F5, you see that it loads also CSS here, and also it shows the page correctly. So what happened when we add this? So we go here to the console and we start seeing that this content security policy is blocking external links to be loaded on my page. And this is where the fun starts. In this case, it already blocked an inline CSS, and also it blocked an external reference on the style for a font. It's actually the font that Laravel uses, right? That railway font that appears. So what we need to do now is actually to extend this policy, this basic policy, to actually allow it to load some information, more external links, information that we need. So how do we do that? So if we go here back to the Spatie information page, it says, well, how you can use it. And then it says you need to add directives. This is the basic directive that we have. And now it says, well, you know what? You can actually extend this class and then use it as your own to extend it and put it more directives inside of it, besides the ones from the basic. So this is exactly what we need. We're going to create our own policy class and then use it on this middleware. So I'm just going to create it inside this HTTP. I call it, well, policies. And then I just, I don't know, call it extended. You can call it whatever you want, right? It's just a class that you need to namespace it here correctly. On the policies, and then here I call it extended. So this extended is an example. So it says that on the HTTP header, this HTTP header that we are loading, we now want to add a new directive saying that I want to allow to load scripts from the google.com. And in this case, on the example that we have here, we see that it says it's style source. So it's not actually the in this case, the script that is a style. So I'm just going to change here to style. And I'm going to say, I want to load from fonts.googleapis.com. And if I do an F5, nothing is going to happen, because it actually is going to say exactly the same message. Why? Because I'm not still using this extended policy. So I go back to the config CSP, and instead of using this one that is here, I'm just going to comment it. I need to use my new one, So my new one is app HTTP policies extended class, right? So this is the one that we need to use and no longer the other one. So since I'm using a new policy called extended, I'm saying that besides using the basic one that came here from the Spatie, this one that already adds all of these directives, and we're going to see what does this mean in 1 second, where it is reflected on the header. We are also going to add this, allow this external link for the style one. So if I do an F5, the first line needs to be removed. So as you can see, now I'm letting that fonts.google API is being loaded on this Laravel to render that one. But besides that, it says that there is some inline source that it cannot load. And this is where it comes another operation that you need to do. So basically saying that I have this style here, but I cannot load inline styles with the basic policy configuration that I have. So it means that besides having that, we need now to use this nonce information that it comes here. So let me go back to the page. Let me go back to the header to show to you. So here on the right, on the headers part, you can see here that I'm already sending this content security header on the response, right? So this is being injected by the middleware made by Spatie, and it actually is being changed already by the extension that I'm creating here with the extended policy, right? So if I double click on it, I'm just going to do a select all and copy here to a new file so you can see this working. So I'm just going to do some enters here very quickly and show to you how this starts to make more sense. So help, there is another one here. Good. So if we now see here the basic one from Spatie. So I'm just going to go back here to this basic. You see it says, for instance, base, connect, default, form, action. So you see it matches these headers that are being, these directives that are being sent on this header. And then there you see one here for script source and style source, there is this information here. And this is very, very important. This is a high security hash string that is generated, and it allows you to match then this hash string on the styles, on the inline styles and inline scripts that you have. So it means that I need to pass somehow this string on my inline style. So how can I do that? Well, the Spatie already talks about it here, using inline scripts and styles. So it says that you are putting here this nonce on the basic policy class that comes with the package. And then it says next, you must add the nonce to your HTML. So again, this is where the browser needs to check that the code that comes on the HTTP header, it's the same that is written here. So all I need to do is just to copy this and use that helper file, that helper function. So let's go here to the resources, views, and here on the style, we just edit here. So if I go back here to the Laravel and then do an F5, voila, we start to see something to happen. So you see that it's still not the same, huh? Like, looks like the font is there, but somehow, you know, it doesn't appear the same. So I'm sure we still have some errors here, that some blocking content security that we need to solve out. So let's see it up. Console, here we go. We still have two of them. It says that there is a default source for the Git static fonts that we also need to load. Very well. So we go back to the extended. And here we add the default one, and then here we write fonts.gistatic.com, and if I do an F5, there you go, the font is finally loaded and I don't have any errors. So at this moment, if you go back here, you see that the page was loaded correctly. We see that we have this content security header that is here. And it's allow, now I have the all the directives that I need to load this page correctly. Now, We can do a lot of things around this part. Huh? I mean, on my learning website, I have more directives than the ones that are here. And for instance, there are some very curious things. For instance, if in case you are inlining scripts, where you need to pay attention to that. So let me give an example. I'm going to open the welcome page here. I'm going to the end, and I'm just going to create here a script type text JavaScript. And I'm just going to put an alert, alert hello world. Now, if I do an F5, there is nothing to show, right? Why? Because it says the same. The page settings as blocking the loading of the resource, alert hello world. See? Now, when you go here, and actually you are inlining code, right? So you go back here and you say, okay, let's put an announce. So I copy here, I go to the end, I pass it here, and voila, here we go. See, when we put the nonce, because we are allowing those ones to be placed on our directive, in this case on the basic policy class, when we pass it here, the browser checks that string, verifies that it's the same that came on the header, and then allows you to process this, this alert. So this was in a nutshell how we can use this package from Spatie. Of course, the package goes more and more in deep in more policies that you, in this case, more directives that you can use. You can also check it on the links that I have on my training, because I point to this page, because here you can see a lot of options that you can have in terms of how you can, for instance, if you put some script and then the script doesn't work well, it gives here examples about how you, what you need to do. But this is something that I really, really encourage you to work on and to put on your website, because surely it will allow you to decrease the level of probability of having website hackings on your website. So that's it. If you have any doubts, always fall back to the Spatie documentation. And of course, you can also contact them in case you have any questions. Thank you very much for watching, and see you back soon. Bye-bye.